You know, you can learn data science for free online. And I'm going to show you how.
So you want to learn data science, huh?
Now that that's out of the way.
Hold on. You were looking for me, as in Andrew Moe, as in the guy who was able to get a 40% raise during the pandemic, flip 3 different offers, and change his data science trajectory. You're looking for how I was able to do the data science thing and how I can help you do it too. I think you've come to the right video. My name is Andrew, this is Professor Meatball, and today we are going to talk to you guys about a very specific topic. How can you get a data science job in the afterscape of the pandemic in 2021 and beyond? Today, if you watch this video, you're going to be able to get actionable steps for your 66 days of data from complete beginner. And if you think you're not a complete beginner, you can join in on any section of this guide. And the best thing about this guide is that I'm going to walk it through with you completely free right now. And if you want a copy of the guide, then please head on over to Patreon, where my patrons already have access to all the links and the fun stuff that we're going to cover today. But without further ado, let's get into this document right now. Is that a Christmas tree behind me? It's not Christmas anymore.
Freak out of here.
All right, back to that clock. That looks nicer. Main caveat about this guide is that it's gonna take only 15 to 30 minutes a day. That's it! Only 15 to 30 minutes a day for 66 days, and you are gonna become a very well-established data scientist in your own regard. People are gonna be holding your hands the entire way because there's gonna be modules, there's gonna be playlists, there's gonna be people helping you, such as me, Ken G, and Kaggle. You're gonna be well taken care of and entirely for free. If you're looking to how to get started for your first 21 days, and I have news for you, it is the $0 Data Science Bible, the original version of the video, which I'm going to link down below, or actually right up here so that you can, actually right over there, maybe it was over here, no, it's over there. Right up there so that you can get a head start on your first 21 days. It requires nothing but a computer with a browser because you don't need to install a single thing. Just you need to have eyes, read, and have a browser, Firefox, Chrome, Opera, whatever you want. So, the Data Science Bible. What I was able to cover in 21 days was the very first part of the 66 days version here. On day 22, you're gonna watch this video right here. It's Professor Meatball. It's you. Where are your glasses? So, watching this video will be able to help get Python installed correctly on your computer for the long run. A lot of people would install Python in a hacky way, and then their dependencies and then their installed packages are all messed up. So, you want to be able to use this video to get started. And the lucky thing is that's all you need to do for day 22. Day 23 to 32, you're going to start watching this playlist. It's Kenji's data science project from scratch, and this is going to be very helpful for 3 main reasons. One, it's going to be able to help you build your own project from the ground up with your own data that you scrape from the worldwide internet. Selenium and Beautiful Soup have been widely used in industry, and this is one of the ways that you can prove that your project was actually something that came from data from the real world instead of a Kaggle toy data set. That's paramount. This is important because then you can start wiping away the sense that you have 0 years of experience. You can start playing around with the idea that, hey, I have consulting experience or freelance experience. I have experience from a specific type of data science work. We'll talk about different tactics in a second about how to break through the catch-22, the glass wall of getting experience without having experience. This project is going to be 7 parts, and it's likely going to take you an entire week and a half, which is why I've allotted you an entire 10 days, from the 23rd to the 32nd day. You can now start blogging as well. If you do a daily blog, or at the very least, put down something in a journal and then compile it into a holistic blog article at the end of the day, you can have a profound impact on your search engine optimization of your profile. This is way more than learning. This is getting to become a data scientist that is renowned, that is well known in the industry, which is right now a closely knit community on LinkedIn and Medium, as well as some YouTubers here and there. Are you done with that project? Congrats, you have accomplished a ton. You've accomplished basically 80% of what I learned in my master's degree, so you are now a very accomplished data scientist. Well, perhaps. You're only halfway done with your 66 days, and your 33rd day you're going to start is doing two more Kaggle micro courses. For the next 10 days, you're going to do the Intro to Machine Learning and the Machine Learning Explainability courses. These courses are going to be a module a day, and you are going to be able to pace it through even if you only have 15 to 30 minutes. After being able to have machine learning under your belt, that is one of the core parts of having a data science toolkit, you're going to start doing lead code questions. Starting at day 45, you're going to start doing lead code because this is the main way to pass a technical interview, which in my opinion is the easiest part of a data science interview. You're gonna have a lot harder time with the product sense and the product landscape and understanding how statistical tests are conducted and interpreted. But the SQL questions should not be the hardest part. So go to this link right here and then start off your lead code journey with SQL questions that are free. You see, lead code wants you to pay something. Well, this is for entirely free. All of the free questions, starting with easy, all the way to the three or four hard questions that they have, if you can ace those without looking at the answers, you are going to be a rock star. Now, if you want to see me go through a couple of questions and explain how I approach these lead code questions, then I will link a video down below and above at the same time. Towards day 46, now that you've had the micro course under your belt, you're gonna wanna start looking into how to use machine learning models in industry, which is gonna help a lot with this article. All machine learning models explained in 6 minutes. Intuitive explanations of the most popular machine learning models. So this is gonna be extremely valuable, being able to explain this in an interview, because ultimately you're gonna have to be able to take these machine learning models that you've now have a gist of because of the two Kaggle courses and explain it to someone who doesn't know a lickety split thing about what, you know, regression and classification and support vector machines are. They just want to know what the business proposition is. So this is gonna be helpful. You're also gonna start wanting to go through the machine learning questions, and luckily Springboard has created a 51 essential machine learning questions and answers. So you are gonna be able to start preparing for those interviews. Day 48 to 54 is when you really wanna start practicing interviews. And I've linked a bunch of actual practice interviews from YouTube by certain friends and by professional companies. We have one machine learning design interview by Data Science J. We have one SQL most asked question by me. We also have one SQL interview question by a Feng data scientist, Tina Huang. And finally, most importantly, I want you to get a Pramp account so that you can start meeting people who are also practicing for the interviews and be an interviewer and an interviewee, trade off roles. And it's entirely free from what I can understand. It is one of the best ways to be able to get data science learning under your belt in an interview sense so that you're not just talking to thin air like me with this camera right now. Final 12 days. Final 2 weeks-ish, you are in the home stretch. I have to say, congratulations for making it this far. One of the most important things that people miss out on, and they have an entire master's degree behind them, or they have an entire boot camp behind them, and they haven't even learned how to cold email. So use the third door technique, the briefcase technique. I covered this with Jeff Lee, who was able to leverage 7 different offers during the pandemic this year. So go ahead and check out that video. I'm gonna link that as well. And check out this video. It's how to write cold emails with Grow With Will, another fellow YouTuber. He makes excellent content about exactly how you should position yourself as a cold emailer, because getting those connections can really help you push your application through the door. Because one of the most important things is, with less than 1 year of experience, you're gonna be at the bottom of the resume stack for most of these positions, and you wanna be able to really have a T-shaped application process. If you've skipped all the way to the end, hey, welcome to the video. You have now reached the part of the interview process where you want to have as many applications that take less than 60 seconds long. Now, this is gonna be from AngelList and LinkedIn and easy apply, and then have a couple of applications where you have just a ton of work put into it. 60 minutes of market research, of aggregating some data that you scraped from Selenium or some other user group, and then having a compelling case to provide a data science hiring manager, or perhaps just anyone on the team who is interested in hearing your story. If you take away anything from this cold email section, it's be approachable. Be someone that they want to be friends with, be a lifelong relationship with. I know in other cultures, it's more likely that you're gonna have a response if you act as a subordinate, as someone who is looking for a mentor. That is not necessarily something that will get you clicks or responses in the American landscape or the North American landscape. So one of the most important things to remember is you want to start building lifelong relationships, because you're getting a job, sure, maybe in the next 1 to 4 years, but what about after the 4 year mark? Well, you're gonna have to find a new job, and all of the friends you've made along the way, even upperclassmen from alumni now that were going to the same school, those people could have helped you transition into your next job. So make sure to stay connected with those connections. Finally, build relationships that last. Really, this is just a general term for any kind of career, but in data science specifically, you're gonna find that it's a very small, closely knit community. So that's the best advice I have for you. This whole time, you were still doing one lead code question a day, you're still blogging, which you started off doing one a day, or perhaps you're still aggregating your blogs and your progress so that you can now put out that Medium article and then send it out into the LinkedIn world. Building that online profile, I cannot stress enough, is so important, and I'm glad you are keeping it up until now. You've made it all the way through. If you want me to go into more detail, I built this document in a live stream, which I'm gonna link up below. And I also have a hard mode, boss mode, 21-day version of this that even has more detail, has even crazier advantages to this one. So if you want access to this document that I have all the links to, then go ahead and throw me a coffee up on Patreon, or if you want the boss mode, that is also in Patreon as well. Hey, my name is Editing Andrew. I'm here to say thank you guys for staying all the way to the end. If you wanted to see exactly what Kenji thinks about this specific guide as well as the boss mode guide, I would really recommend checking out the live stream we did 2 days ago. This is going to give you a good sense of what Ken's take is on learning data science in 2021, and it'll give you more context about exactly what you should work on holistically outside of this guide. Now back to your regular Andrew. See ya. If you leave a comment down below, I'm going to comment on it. I'm going to reply to you. It's going to be a conversation, and you are going to feel a big part of this community. If you want to feel like you can talk to me directly, then go ahead and go on Discord. That's going to be in a link down below. If you want to support me, then click any of the links down below, including getting some free stocks from Webull, getting some free audiobooks from Audible, or if you buy a lot of stuff on Amazon, then start your session with one of the Amazon affiliate links down below. It costs nothing to you, and it makes me a couple of pennies, so that's nice. If you're interested in collaborating, I would love to shout you out in a future video just like this one. So go ahead and screenshot this video, tag me on Instagram, Andrew Mo Money, and I will pick you. I will pick you to be shouted out in one of the next videos. For now, but not ever for forever. I will see you guys in the next one. Please watch another video. I'm gonna suggest one right after the cool outro sequence, but for now, peace. You can have a
This is actually not going to be a very fun video.